Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 17.6 Beta 4. iOS 17.6 Beta 4 is out to developers, and public beta testers should get it soon, either by the time you're watching this video or sometime tomorrow. Now, this was a bit of a surprise, as many people thought we'd have iOS 17.6 RC, but it looks like Apple's got that planned for a later date, pushing back the final release date of iOS 17.6. We'll talk more about that a little bit later, but this update came in at 431.1 megabytes on my 15 Pro Max. It was about the same size on the iPad Pro M4 as well. Along with this, Apple also released quite a few other updates with iPadOS 17.6 Beta 4, watchOS 10.6 Beta 4, along with tvOS and HomePodOS 17.6 Beta 4, macOS 14.6 Beta 4, visionOS 1.3 Beta 4, and other macOS updates as well for previous devices. Now, this particular update does have a couple small changes in it. Let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to General, then About. As you can see, the build number is 21G5075A. The A at the end usually signifies we're very close to a final release. I would expect the next one to be the RC version. As far as a modem update, well, this update does not have a new modem update in it. iOS 17.6 Beta 2, Beta 3, and Beta 4 all have the same exact modem update. Now, as far as new features, well, Apple continues to refine this, and there's a new update for family sharing with an accept or decline button. That's very small, but if you do have family sharing, so if I go into family and then you go to add someone, you'll actually, the person receiving it will have a new button to accept or decline. I have my family sharing all filled up with my family, so I'm not able to test it, but it's something that should pop up. Also, there's many new wording changes. So maybe you go into your account here at the top, and within your sign in and security settings, you have legacy contact. You can set this up. And once you do, there's some wording changes that will be received for the person actually receiving the invite to be the legacy contact. So some very small wording changes here. There are many other wording changes throughout, but nothing obvious, just refinements. Basically, this update has a few different changes, things I've mentioned before with the TV app, with Find My when it comes to the Apple Pencil using it on the iPad, and also things such as updated messages for when you get something in the port on the bottom. If you get water in it, they've changed the wording there, and deleting photos will delete permanently now. Just lots of really small wording changes, and maybe some changes to contactless payments. So really nothing to note with Beta 4, but I just wanted to make you aware that there was an update. A couple other things worth noting though are some bug fixes to things such as storage. So if you go into General and then About, where you actually have the storage down here, it's actually showing more storage for quite a few people. In fact, basically 2 to 4 gigabytes extra of storage every time. Thanks to Matt Mills for sending that in. Basically, every time he's updated to the next beta, it's freed up 2 to 4 gigabytes of additional storage. So that's great to see. And another thing I noticed right away is AirDrop definitely seems a little better on this iPad. Prior to this, if we went into settings, then you're under AirDrop. AirDrop for some reason would just switch to off, and then I couldn't AirDrop. I couldn't switch it back on. I would go back out and it would still be back off. I'd have to do a hard reset on the iPad to fix that. It seems like it's fixed in this update. Lots of other things have been fixed, such as notifications not coming in, Bluetooth headphone issues should be fixed, and it looks like they've updated the alarm and timer issues, so that should be fixed. So no more alarm bug, but we don't know that 100%. The standby bug is fixed, and let me show you that. So on a dock, now I did hear from someone with beta 3 that it wasn't fixed for them, but it definitely seems like it's fixed in all of the betas I've had, where you can press and hold once it unlocks with Face ID, and then you can fully edit this with different colors and more. So this is something I couldn't do before. Once beta 2 came out, or beta 1, it actually resolved this issue. So I'm glad to see that. It's definitely much better as far as that goes. As far as the screen time bug, well, they haven't said whether or not they've fixed it, but it looks like it's still an issue in iOS 18 betas as well, but it's working for me in this beta. As far as remaining bugs, well, the wallpaper dimming bug is definitely still there, and you can see it on this vibrant wallpaper. Swipe home, it desaturates pretty dramatically. It looks great here and then desaturates like crazy. I really wish they would stop this and fix this. I'm not sure why they haven't yet. I know some people think it's a feature. It's not. It's a bug from earlier iOS 17 updates. As far as overall performance, well, it seems to be performing as you would expect. Things seem nice and smooth, and I've really had no issues whatsoever. Hopefully you can see that at 60 frames per second, how smooth it is. If I scroll, it's just super smooth in general. So it looks like it's doing pretty well. It should be very refined at this point. And as far as benchmarks, I did run those as well. So if we go into Geekbench 6, we have 2,905 for single core, 7,137 for multi-core. If we take a look at the history prior to this, it was a little bit higher, but it's within the margin of error. No real issue here. Much better performance as far as the Geekbench scores go compared to iOS 18. So that could be an issue with just the software or something else. When it comes to battery life, well, it takes a few days to know, but iOS 17.6 beta 3 was quite good for a lot of people. In fact, if we go down to battery health, go back in here, battery health, you'll see I'm at 40 cycles with 100% capacity. And if we go to the last 10 days, of course, I haven't been using this full time, but most people are saying it easily gets them through the day, and it's some of the best battery life they've had in some time. So that's great to see, but again, it takes a few days to measure that. So if you're wondering if you should install iOS 17.6 beta 4, if you're already on the 17.6 betas, of course you could, but if you're on iOS 18 betas, you won't have the option for this either way. So I would just continue with the iOS 18 public betas if you're on that. As far as the release date, well, I would expect iOS 17.6 RC as soon as probably next week sometime. It could be next Tuesday. And as far as iOS 17.6's final release, probably a couple weeks from now, maybe the week of the 29th. Now that also goes along with what we expect for iOS 18 beta 4 and iOS 18 public beta 2. Based on what we had last year, Apple released the public beta on July 12th and then the next public beta or beta 4 on July 25th. Based on that, I would not expect another beta for iOS 18 until the week of the 29th. So based off of that, that's when I would expect it. Other than that, I would not expect any updates in between. iOS 17.5.2 was apparently scrapped, so maybe we won't see that, and in a couple weeks we'll have fixes with security updates and more with iOS 17.6. So there's not a whole lot more to talk about with iOS 17.6. Very minor update. It's fairly small, just a bunch of wording changes at this point and refinements, but it's good to see it refined and stable. So definitely something worth trying out if you're already on 17.6, or maybe you're on iOS 17.5.1 and a little bit frustrated with it. While I wouldn't normally recommend switching to a beta, this seems to fix a lot of issues. Let me know your experience with iOS 17.6, or if you're just running iOS 18 betas, or you're holding off on the current public version. Let me know in the comments below, and of course I'll link this wallpaper in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe, and if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.